Ever since interest rates started climbing again about a month ago, the high-yielding real estate investment trusts, which investors have been treating as fixed income equivalents, have been hammered. But I don't want you to throw the baby out with the bathwater, which is why tonight I think it's a good time to take a closer look at Ventas, VTR, the healthcare real estate investment trust that owns everything from senior housing to skilled nursing facilities, medical office buildings, and a few hospitals. 1,500 assets in 47 states, two Canadian provinces, and the United Kingdom. Ventas sports a hefty 4.6% yield. You saw rates today went down. This is terrific opportunity. Company's benefiting from some powerful demographic trends. Gets 55% of its operating income from senior housing, and the older members of the aging baby boomer generation are now in their late 60s. A lot of demand, not a lot of supply coming on. The other reason I like Ventas, it's a consolidator. Most recently, at the beginning of this month, we learned that the company's acquiring American Realty Capital Healthcare. That's another healthcare REIT with similar exposure for $2.6 billion, as well as shelling out $900 million for 29 senior living centers in Canada. And considering how cheaply Ventas can borrow money, they have the ability to do a lot more deals going forward that could raise the dividend, that could raise the earnings. Let's take a closer look with Debra Cafaro, the chairman and CEO of Ventas and one of my 21 bankable chief executives from Get Rich Carefully to get a better sense of how her company's doing and where it's headed. Ms. Cafaro, welcome back to Mad Money.
Good to see you.
You had a fantastic presentation recently at the NAREIT conference. I just want everyone to hear this one number. Maybe the only number you need. Deliver consistent superior total returns. 3,430% increase if you bought the stock since 12/31/1999.
That's
right. How can a REIT deliver that kind of performance?
Well, we're in a great spot at Ventas. I think you picked out some of the key points that we have. We are fueled by the aging demographic in the U.S. We're in, domestically, we can grow. It's a highly fragmented trillion-dollar real estate market. We're starting to go international as well, and that's a very untapped market. We have a low cost of capital and a great team and a lot of great customers, and we can continue to grow externally as well as grow internally.
Well, if it's such a fractured market, Deb, I know when I see companies going to Canada, Canada be hard. Target was hard to get in there. And then UK, a little far flung. Do you need to go to those places, or are the opportunities so great that you can't pass up?
Well, we don't need to. As I said, there's a trillion here. Yeah. Only 12% of that is owned by the public REITs, and it's highly fragmented, it's consolidating, it's very dynamic. So lots of opportunities there. But I would say where we find other countries that have strong economies, that have aging demographics, that have evolved healthcare systems, and where we think they provide future channels for growth, we do want to establish beachhead investments there, and that's what we've done in both Canada and the UK.
Okay, now I like people to think long term. You guys think even longer term than most, because I feel you have a 25-year plan, 144% growth in the plus 75% cohort by 2040 with minimal supply.
Yes.
So you've got the longest runway of almost any company I follow.
We do. I mean, we all know that the aging demographic is very powerful. The demand is inelastic for most of the services that are provided, whether they're medical office or senior housing or skilled nursing. And importantly, the 75 and over people who make more than $50,000 a year, they're growing by a third just by 2017. And household incomes or household net worths tend to be $678,000. So we have a wealthy aging demographic here in the U.S., and that is what is fueling really our business success.
And that's important because people think, well, they may rely on the government. No, it's mostly private pay.
More
and
than
your
half,
places
yes.
are, I mean, because yes. I know your facilities, they're not cheap, but that's because people want high quality.
People do. Our communities are mostly high barrier to entry markets. They're serving that upper middle and upper middle class senior population. Mm-hmm. And that's a great strength as well. People need and want these services. I can say that.
Absolutely. Now, Deb, there's a piece that came out in May. Goldman Sachs, always liked your stock. Is bigger better the case for smaller large cap healthcare real estate investment trusts? They're saying that the best performance lately is coming from the companies that simplify operations and spin-offs. Is this just faddish and what we really want to do is just stick with the knitting?
Well, the healthcare REITs are a diversified business model. And I think that we can't confuse, investors sometimes do like pure play, but they like pure play that have operations. Remember, Ventas is a financial company. Right. What we do is raise money and we're an investment machine. When you do that, your cost of capital is important, and diversification and scale drive down cost of capital. And so our business model, I think, does benefit right. from diversification and scale, and it's been well accepted by investors. And I really do believe that the best way to deliver those consistent superior returns is on a diversified model.
Well, it's empirical that you have, and it's empirical that being consolidators better than,
yes.
than a company that maybe put together assets that don't all belong under one
exactly.
roof.
Exactly.
And yours clearly do.
And also, having those different segments is a very underappreciated investment attribute, because we want to be good capital allocators and make early cycle investments. And so we can move around the wheel and pick the segments at any given point in time that can be both accretive and value creating.
Well,
so that's very important to our overall total return proposition.
Well, you've done a fabulous job. It's why I've been featuring you as one of the best 21 CEOs, and just continual good success for all your shareholders.
Thank you, Jim. That's
Debra Cafaro, the chairman and CEO of Ventas. It's very rare, people, that this stock is put on sale at all. And when it does go on sale, you have to buy it. Stick with Cramer.